सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमामस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तिरिहाय दक्षिणामूर्ते नमः सहना भवतु सहनं भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै च ब्रह्मदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशम् शुभै शरणमहं प्रपद्यं शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमः यं सुखनित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धे सुज्ञानिनः बाह्य प्रवृत्ति न संभवति इति आरोप देयर वाज एन आरोप and it was answered by saying that there are nana prarabdhas and based on that jnani vyavahara is also different. Let's look at the tippana. In the tippana it is said jnanam sarvesham samam iti atra ayam shlokaha prasiddhataya kathyate. There is one shloka which is mentioned to say that jnana is same, although the jnani's prarabdha is different, jnani appears to be different across the board, but jnana is same. Krishno bhogi shukastyagi nrupo janaka ragav vasishtak karma karta cha tayete jnanina sama iti. So Krishna was a bhogi. You see, Krishna had Krishna is Ananda Swarupa. So he indulged through and through, if you look at it. His Leela is very famous in Bhagavata. Thousands of wives are discussed. So it's a portrayal of Ananda Swarupa where Bhoga is shown in the avatara. Whereas in Rama, you don't see that. In Rama, you don't see that kind of Bhoga. Rama is representative of dharma. But Rama also had prarabdha of ruling the kingdom later. 14 years of vanvasa was also there. So dukkha was also shown there. However, jnana being there, prarabdha being different, the behavior is different. Krishna is bhogi. Shuka was Tyagi. Whereas Janaka and Raghava is Rama. Both are Nrupas, both are kings, both were kings. Then Vasishta is Karma Karta. Kept on doing karma because he is shown as Vanaprastha. So Karma Karta do, Grahastha or Vanaprastha, if you look at it, still karma he continued to do. We see so many, even we see in Vishwamitra also continued to do Homa Ityadi. We see he borrowed Rama and Lakshmana to protect his Yajna Ityadi. Therefore, we know that there were some Munis who had Jnana but still were Karma Kartas. But Jnaninaha Samaha. Jnana is same, so they are similar. Jnanis are similar, but Jnana is same. इत्थम एतेषां प्रारब्ध भेदात् व्यवहार भेदेपि ज्ञानं सर्वेषां समानमेव इति सांप्रदायिक श्लोकार्थः. Although the ज्ञानीज आर डिफरेंट ड्यू टू प्रारब्ध भेद, देयर इज नो ज्ञान भेद दैट इज शोन देयर. लेट मी सी. ओके, वी विल फिनिश द टिप्पणा. ननु तत्त्वबोधवतामपि रागादिमत्वेन वैषम्योपलम्भात् ज्ञानस्य अपि मुक्तिहेतुत्वं निश्चेतुं न शक्यम् इति आशंक्य So there's a question here. If even after Tattva Bodha, Atma Bodha, Jnana, Prarabdha Bheda is talked about, but what is it really? Ragadi Bheda. So Ragadi Matvena Hetuna Vaishamya Upalambhat. If you accept there is a difference due to Raga being different in each and every Jnani, even after Jnana Utpatti, then how do you ascertain that Jnana is Mukti Hetu? Jnana cannot be seen to be Mukti Hetu at all. Mukti Hetutvam Nishchetum Jnanasyapi Mukti Hetutvam Nishchetum Nashakyam. You cannot say Idamittham Jnana is there, he is Mukta. Because Ragadi continues to be there. This is what you are saying, says the Purva Pakshi. Ragadir Vyadhyadi Vat Arabdha Karma Phalatvat Mukti Pratibandhakatvam Asiddham. It is not well known, just like Vyadhi Ityadi, Ragadehe Vyadhivat. So Janma, Mrityu, Jara, Vyadhi we talk about, where Vyadhi is disease. So Ragadehe Rogavat, Vyadhivat means Rogavat, Arabdha Karma Phalatvat Mukti Pratibandhakatvam Asiddham. Just like rogas are pratibandhakas, vyadhis are pratibandhakas to anyone wanting to do something. Similarly, ragadis, ragadehe arabdha karma phalatvat. Since it is also prarabdha karma phala, if that is what you are saying, then mukti pratibandhakatvam asiddham. So this is an aropa anyway. Mukti pratibandhakatvam is actually prasiddha in shastras. In Advaita Shastras at least. Ataha na shastrarthi vipratipattavyam ityahu Vidyaranya Swaminaha. So Vidyaranya Swamiji in the Panchadashi, 7 chapters, Chitradipa, he talks about Prarabdha Karma. Even in Mula, that is what is referred to explain this Vyavastha of variety across Jnanis. Prarabdha Karma Nanatvad बुद्धानाम अन्यथान्यथा वर्तनं तेन शास्त्रार्थे भ्रमितव्यं न पंडितैः कथं तर्हि प्रतिपत्तव्यम् इत्याहु. सो पंडितैः न भ्रमितव्यं. दोस हू अंडरस्टैंड शास्त्रास हैव स्कॉलरशिप्स दे शुड नॉट जस्ट रीड द शास्त्रास स्टडी देम एंड थिंक दैट ओ लेट मी एनालाइज द ज्ञानीस. यू कैन नॉट डू दैट. व्हाई? अन्यथा अन्यथा बुद्धानाम अपि प्रारब्ध कर्म नानात्वात् अन्यथा अन्यथा वर्तनम्. सो शास्त्रार्थेन भ्रमितव्यम्. इन द आइडिया ऑफ द शास्त्रास व्हाट इज बेसिकली बीइंग सेड इज ऑल ज्ञानीज आर अवेयर दैट दे आर ब्रह्म. द शरीर प्रारब्ध डज नॉट चेंज, देयरफॉर यू शुड नॉट गेट कंफ्यूज. Neither should the panditas get confused, nor should they confuse others. How should they understand then? Katam tari pratipattavyam ityapyahu svasva karma anusarena vartantam te yatha tatha avishishta avishashtaha. Sarva bodha avishishtaha. Sarva mukti riti sthitihi iti. How should you understand then? Yatha svasva karma anusarena vartantam tatha. Just like te, te jnaninaha, yatha svasva karmanusarena vartantam. All karmas are not same. Just like everyone has their own work to do, similarly jnanis have also their own prarabdha to live in the circumstances. However, sarva, sarvesham bodha avishishtaha. There is no vaishishtyam, there is no visheshana by which you can differentiate the jnana in each. Sarvesham jnaninam bodhastu samanameva. Thereby, sarva muktir api avishishta. You can convert this to strilinga. It is sthiti. This is a fact. Sarvesham muktihi api avishishta. अहम ब्रह्मास्मि इति ज्ञानोदय काले एव अविद्यात्मक उपादान कारण विनश्यति. अविद्या विच इज द मटेरियल कॉज उपादान कारण फॉर शरीरद्वय because it is karana sharira. And avaranatmaka vikshepatmaka avidya, that is vinashta at what time? Aham brahma asmiti jnanodaya kale eva. At that moment itself avidya is gone. Tat karyabhuta jagat chidabhasadaya api bhajyante eva. Thereby the jagat, which is avidya, maya karya, and chidabhasa, which is also pratibimbita or abhasa in avidya, that will also go because there is no medium to reflect. Thereby it is sublated, negated. Bhajyante eva tathapi prarabdha karma rupam nimittam yavat avatishtate tavat jnana badhitapi deha jagat chidabhasadayo anuvartamanayo pratiyeran. But there is a pratiti of the prapancha continuing, bhogas continuing, at least from the perspective of others, as long as jnani sharira prarabdha is there. Prarabdhavasane cha na pratiyeran. Then after the prarabdha ends, there is vidaya mukti, there is no pratiti of jnani bhoga. Iyam eva videha muktihi, this is called as videha mukti. Uttama madhyama kanishta adhama tara adhama tama bhedena panchavidam prarabdham. Five categories of prarabdhas are discussed. So what are those? Sarvada ajanva maranam vairagya hetu bhutam nivritti pradhanam prarabdham uttamam. So sarvada ajanva maranam, right from janma to marana there is vairagya. So there is purva shravana krita jnana, but prarabdha vashat there is janma, but after janma that janma itself is prarabdha bhoga. There is lot of pain in janma. As it is for the mother, it is so for the child also. So the newborn has garbhavasa dukkha and then janma dukkha. After that, prarabdha seizing in a sense, prarabdha which is an obstacle to jnana nishtha seizing, but prarabdha for the sharira to continue being there, what happens? The person will be a vairagi. And that is uttama prarabdha. Yatha shuka vamadeva sanakadi prarabdham. Just like shukadeva, vamadeva and sanakadi munis, they had this kind of prarabdha. They were on nivritti marga since childhood itself. Jnaneshwar ityadi. Adau pravritti hetu bhutam api paschat nivritti hetu bhutam prarabdham madhyamam. Then the madhyama prarabdha is when before there is pravritti, like Yajnavalkya, but later stage what happens? There is nivritti, one takes to sannyasa. Yatha Yajnavalkyadi prarabdham. This is the uttama and madhyama prarabdha. Sada pravritti hetu bhutam prarabdham kanishtam yatha janakadi prarabdham. So like Janaka, who always remained a king pre and post jnanotpatti, thereby his prarabdha is called as kanishta prarabdha. Now this is looking at jivan mukti ananda also, which will be discussed in the Moola. Now these are the three categories which we understand, we would assume also if we were not told. We can understand the difference between jnanis and uttama madhyama kanishta. Now what is this adhama tara and adhama tama? So worse prarabdha, even of a jnani. Look at that. Adau nivritti hetu bhutam sat paschat pravritti hetu bhutam prarabdham adhama taram. Reverse of Yajnavalkya. Initially there was vairagya, but after jnanotpatti one starts getting more and more bhoga. A trap to take away jivan mukti ananda. Imagine this, you know, in childhood you liked something, as you grew you outgrew the bhoga of whatever you liked as well. You started liking other things. The same things didn't give you enough ananda. You started looking at different vishayas for different ananda, which is a fact for everyone. We outgrow the objects that we considered as the source of pleasure and look for other sources as we grow up. This is human nature. Now, if somebody remembers your earlier stage of life and brings you a gift which will consume your time, and you have to give up the other sources befitting your age, how it is going to block your ananda and not going to give you ananda the way in childhood you used to get with the same sources? Similar is the case of these fellows, these jnanis, these fellow jnanis, so to say. Adav nivritti hetu bhutam sat paschat pravritti hetu bhutam prarabdham adamataram. So they go back to Vishayas after getting Atmananda because of Prarabdha, which says that this person should have Bhoga. He has earned it earlier, he has craved for it earlier. Now even if he doesn't want it, he will be forced to enjoy or suffer. Thereby what will happen is that this Nivritti, which has led him to Atmananda, that Atmananda will reduce. It is all Atmananda, but it is manifest in Vishayas now. Therefore, it is Adhama Prarabdha, Adhama Tara Prarabdha. Not Kanishta is Adhama, and this fourth one is Adhama Tara. Worse, and the worst of that is next. But anyway, before that, Yatha, examples are given. Who had this? In Shastras, you see, Shikidhvaja, Yatha Shikidhvaja, Alarka, Hugana Priyavratadi Prarabdham. So Shikidhvaja was a king. I think he had Chudala was his wife. Both were given Atmajnana. Chudala got Atmajnana quite soon. His wife got, the queen got the Atmajnana pretty soon, and she had Vairagya while being in the palace. Shikidhvaja thought that it is not possible. There are so many sages who have spent many years and lives even, but still they have not got Atmajnana. How can she get it? Over a period of time, he also started getting Vairagya. He retired to the forest for several years, and then through Jnana, that Jnana settled down, which was taught earlier, and then he too became a Jnani. He went back to the palace and then he lived a life of a king. Thereby, his prarabdha is Adhamatara prarabdha. He had Vairagya, which went away after Jnanotpatti. There was more prarabdha bhoga. The queen also, to justify that she had Jnana, she started, earning siddhis. She got siddhis as well to showcase to her husband that I have Jnana. So there is some story like this in in Bhagavatam or in, I think mostly in Vasishta Rama, this thing, Yoga Vasishta. Then there is Alarka also, who had similar thing is discussed about Alarka also. Hugana, I am not sure, but must be very similar. Priyavrata was son of Manu. So the son of Manu, he also had Jnana, but he had to do his job. As Manuputra, he had to get this praja going. Thereby, he was also having what kind of prarabdha? Adhamatara prarabdha. The last type, the worst of the prarabdha is Kamachara Kamavada Kama Bhakshadi Hetu Bhutam Prarabdham Adhamatamam. The worst prarabdha is when a person has to face kama even after jnanotpatti. So continues to have kamachara and continues to discuss that also, kamavada, and indulges also. Kama bhakshadi hetu bhutam prarabdham adamatamam. Example given is shocking. If you don't know about Dattatreya story. So, yatha Dattatreya adi prarabdham. See, Dattatreya was a jnani who has taught even Parashurama and considered as what? Considered as Devata. Devata as in manifestation of the triad Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha. However, you know, there is a story as to I don't want to go to the story, but there was karma pending due to which, you know, he was born. Now, not going into that story, but even after Jnanotpatti, what happened? People started praising him. Praising him so much so, but he was a Vairagi really. Vairagi really in the sense, he was not interested in being in crowds. He wanted to be an introvert. But what happened is that people started following him where he went. Thereby he had a lot of siddhis. In fact, he is considered as the Adi Guru in some sampradayas of Tantra. Many sampradayas of Tantra rather. Dattatreya is considered as a Tantra Guru. Even in Kaula. Anyway, we'll see what this is in Moola, some of it, towards the end of the book. So Dattatreya Adi Prarabdham, what was it? What he started doing then to avoid crowds, he started doing something which people don't respect. Meaning he started Kamachara. To keep away crowds, he wanted to be alone. Therefore, he came out from his, he hid in the Samudra. There also people followed. So he came out of that with many women. So all this is talked about. To show that he tried to avoid people by showing that he is not a sadhu person. Then people started leaving him, but then he was stuck with these others that he had, found company of. Anyway, that's an aside to show that there is adhama tama prarabdha also. What is the difference in jnana of Shukadeva Ityadi or Yajnavalkya or Janaka or Shikidhvaja Ityadi or Dattatreyadi? No difference in Jnana. So that's a tippana there. Back to the Moola, 485th Avarta se Jnanino Videha Moksha Tyaga Paraloke Chan Channa Jayate. Patra Kechana Akshipanti. So what has been said? This Siddhanta. Siddhanta is Videha Moksha Tyaga Paraloka Ichha. What is Videha Moksha Tyaga? Jivan Mukti may or may not be there. Ananda may or may not be there. As we saw, based on the Prarabdha. However, Jnanotpatti taking place, Videha Mukti is guaranteed. If there are no doubts about Aham Brahmasmi, if one can stay with that understanding, without a doubt ever, then the person will get Videha Mukti. Now, who would want to give Videha Mukti, give it up and go to another loka? So there is an Aropa, Vaikuntha Asha may be there, Kailasha Asha may be there, Brahma Loka, let me go and have a look. These all ideas may be there, just like there is Bhoga here. Even after Jnanotpatti, there may be bhoga in other lokas also. Why not the Jnani travel to other worlds as well, giving up Videha Moksha? So Videha Mukti Tyaga, Videha Moksha Tyaga. Na Parloka Ichha Cha Na Jayate. Patra Kechana Akshipanti Jivan Mukti Sukham Tyaktva Tuchha Vishe Bhoge Pravrutto Videha Moksham Api Tyaktva Vaikuntha Adi Loke Ichhaya Tattal Lokam Api Prapnuyaditi. If a person is willing to give up or unwillingly gives up Atma Sukha after Jnanotpatti and indulges for Vishaya Sukha, then that Jnani may give up the Videha Mukti also and go to another loka, Vaikuntha Ityadi. Why not? That Ichha is possible. Naivam na eva ayam sambhavatya akshepaha. This akshepa is not valid. Why? Jivan Mukti Sukatyagaha Bhoga Pravrutisha Jnaninaha Prarabdha Balat Sambhavati. Over and over it has been hammered in this text that it is all due to Prarabdha. Jivan Mukti Sukatyaga by a Jnani, meaning giving up Samadhi, Janya Sukha. which is Atma Sukha, one has Bhoga Pravrutti. That is due to Prarabdha Vasha. Prarabdha is Bala, Prabala Prarabdha. That will draw the Jnani out of Samadhi. Even if he wants to go into Samadhi, it will draw him out and take him circumstantially into some Vishaya Bhoga. Videha Mukti Tyaga. However, Videha Mukti Tyaga is when the Prarabdha is over. So, Prarabdha Bala is no longer working there. At the end moment, when Prarabdha is over, the Deha Pata is going to take place. Then the Jnani has no influence of Prarabdha at all. The body is going to drop off. Then where is the question of Videha Mukti Tyaga? So, Videha Mukti Tyaga Paraloka Gamanam Chatasya Naiva Sambhavati. That is not possible. Yataha, why? Jnaninah Pranaha Bahirna Gacchanti. Pranas resolve there itself. They don't travel at all. Natasya Prana Utkramanti Ityadi Shrutehe. Because the Shruti says so, Tasmana Paraloka Gamana Jnanina Sambhavati. Paraloka Gamana, Vaikuntha, Kailasa, Brahmaloka, this is all not possible. Pitruloka Ityadi, Swargadi. Videha Moksha Tyagaschana Sambhavati. And Videha Mukti cannot be given up because that is the Niyama. The body was put together, it will disintegrate on the end of Prarabdha. Sukshma Sharira was put together across each and every kalpa the way it was there earlier, meaning manifest from the seed form. Although it was anadi, it is santa. Santa meaning after jnana and after prarabdha being over, the sukshma sharira will also disintegrate into its basic components. Yataha jnanena nishyesha jnana nivruttau prarabdha bhoganantaram stula sukshma sharira Akara Parinatasya. That which has taken shape into stool and Sukshma Sharira, what has taken the shape of that? The material. The material cause, Upadana Karana, which is Karana Sharira or Mula Jnana. So Mula Jnanasya, Stula Sukshma Sharira, Akara Parinatasya, Mula Jnanasya, Swadhisthana Chaitanya, Nishesha Pravilaya, Eva Videha Moksha Iti Kathyate. What happens to that avidya? Whatever is the adhisthana in that, it will resolve. Sarpa resolves into Rajju. Similarly, this Mula Jnana also will vanish into Chaitanya, Swadhisthana Chaitanya. That itself is Videha Moksha. Sacha Ajnana Nashe Avashyam Bhavati. When Ajnana goes away, there won't be two Shariras which are stool and sukshma. So sukshma sharira will also wither away into its components. Mula jnani avashishte nivruttasya jnanasya punar apateva videha muktir na siddhyet. Videha mukti won't be possible in which case? When mula jnana remains. Or when mula jnana goes away, nivruttasya jnanasya punar apate sati. Or when Mula Jnana comes back again. Both cases are invalidated. You cannot have Mula Jnana remaining after Prarabdha being over in the case of a Jnani. And you cannot have Punarutpatti of Ajnana. Therefore, Videha Mukti not being possible itself is wrong. Videha Mukti will not be possible only in two cases. If Mula Jnana continues or Ajnana comes up again. Both cases are not possible. Mula Jnana Virodhi Jnanodaya Samakalami Vacha Ajnanam Na Avashishyate. Mula Jnana itself does not remain when Jnana takes place. There is a Lesha, but that Lesha is not Avashishta. It is that Lesha is there only as long as Prarabdha is there. It is inferred. That Lesha cannot be accepted to be there when Karya itself goes away. Because the Prarabdha Karya is there, so long the Lesha, Avidya Lesha is accepted, but Avidya Lesha is not Avashishta Ajnana, Mula Ajnana, when Prarabdha goes away, when Karya itself isn't there. Karana need not be inferred anymore. Pramanato Nashtam Ajnanam Api Na Punarutpadyate. Through Pramana, when the Ajnana is Nashta, it will not come up again. Tataha na Videha Moksha Bhava Sambhavati. This Videha Mukti giving up is not पॉसिबल विदेह मोक्ष त्यागे परलोक गमने च ज्ञानिना ज्ञानिनः इच्छा न जायेत बट कैन देर बी इच्छा यू आर सेइंग इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल बट ड्यू टू इच्छा इट कैन बी पॉसिबल व्हाई नॉट कैन ज्ञानी हैव एन इच्छा यतः ज्ञानिना इच्छा भी तावत केवलं प्रारब्धादीना एव जायते इवन दी ज्ञानी इच्छा नॉट ओनली भोग दी इच्छा फॉर दी भोग being there is also due to prarabdha. Let's say there is bhoga due for a jnani. Does the jnani say, no, I don't want it, I don't want it? Some jnani say, I don't want it, I don't need it. Others take. They may or may not need it, it is irrelevant. One may say, oh, something has been offered to someone, that person is a jnani, why should he take it? He should refuse. But there is prarabdha due. How do you know what prarabdha is there for the sharira? Jnani knows that it is prarabdha due to which something has come to him. Not only that, ichha not being there is also prarabdha. So something has come to him, but the bhoga should not. So bhoga is due only of having a look or proximity of some vishaya. There the prarabdha is over, then the ichha in the jnani's antakarna will be to reject it. Because there is no further bhoga due. So jnani will not have an ichha to consume that vishaya. He'll say, I don't want it. Whereas some other jnani may have bhoga complete due by prarabdha. Therefore the vishaya comes to the person and then he accepts it also. Why? Because there is raga towards that vishaya. This is just an example. So, ragotpatti in the antakkarana, how is it possible for a jnani? Again, due to prarabdha. So, kevalam prarabdha idina eva, iccha api. Iccha is raga. Yavatim samagrim vina jnaninav prarabdha bhogo na jayeta, tavatim eva samagrim prarabdham janayati. Only so much. Only so much iccha will be there. Samagri, talked about Samagri, as much as the Prarabdha Bhoga is due. Not less, not more. Nahi Ichcham vina Bhogo Jayeta. Bhoga is not possible without Ichcha, so Ichcha has to be inferred. How can Jnani have Ichcha? Oh, it is possible due to Prarabdha. Just like Jnani's Bhoga is possible, Ichcha is also possible. Tasma Jnanina Ichcha api Prarabdha Phala Bhutam Bhuta eva. So Ichcha is also what? Prarabdha phala bhuta. It is a phala of prarabdha. Ichcha is not karana. You should not look at it as karana for bhoga. But it is phala of prarabdha. Because bhoga as phala of prarabdha is due. Similarly, the bhoga ichcha as karana of bhoga is due as prarabdha phala also. लोकांतरे वा इहलोके वा शरीरांतर संबंधो वा ज्ञानिनः प्रारब्धाधीनो न जायते इत्येतत् प्रागेव अस्मिन् तरंगे प्रतिपादितम् इट हैज ऑलरेडी बीन मेंशन्ड व्हाई ज्ञानी वोंट हैव परलोक इच्छा इत्यादि तस्मात् ज्ञानिनः प्रारब्ध बलादपि विदेह मोक्ष त्यागे वा परलोक गमने वा नैव इच्छा संभवति सो इच्छा टुवर्ड्स परलोक गिविंग ऑफ विदेह मुक्ति इज नॉट पॉसिबल दृढ़तर ज्ञानिनो टिप्पण दृढ़तर ज्ञानिनो मोक्षेच्छा भावे अपि मुक्तिर जायते इत्यत्र भाष्यकार वचनम् भगवान भाष्यकार सेज दैट मुक्ति इज पॉसिबल फॉर अ दृढ़तर ज्ञानी पॉसिबल इन द सेंस मुक्ति इज डेफिनेट इवन इफ मोक्ष इच्छा इटसेल्फ इजंट देयर नाउ इफ द पूर्व पक्षी हैज मेड एन आरोप As to Ichcha may be there. How about Ichcha may be there, which was there earlier before Jnana, and that Ichcha continues to be there, oh, it would have been good to have a look at other lokas also. Assume that, supposing such an Ichcha is there. Meaning what? Mukti Ichcha isn't there. Videha Mukti Ichcha isn't there. Then what will happen? Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, Dehatma Jnana Vajnanam Dehatma Jnana Badakam Atmanya Bhavedyasya Sa Nechanabhi Muchyateti. Even if there is no Mukti Ichcha, that person will get Mukti. Why? Dehatma Jnana Badakam. That Ichcha, which is due to Dehatma Jnana, Deha being Atma, that has been negated by what? Dehatma jnanavat jnanam. There is a typo here, it should be jnanam. So dehatma jnanavat jnanam, atma jnanam, yasya bhavati. Saha na icchannapi muchyate. So he will be freed even if he does not want mukti. Or if he has some other iccha also, he will be freed from everything. Videha mukti will take place because he has no dehatma jnana now. He has that jnana, atma jnana, which is dehatma jnana badaka. Atmaniya bhavet. Atmani eva jnanam bhavet. So, jnana is atma jnana because atmani eva yasya jnanam bhavet. Kim vata? Dehatma jnana vata. That will be dehatma jnana badaka and thereby saha nechannapi muchyate. Swapnat prabuddhasya. Example is swapna. Swapnat prabuddhasya yatha swapna bhranti nivrutti parityage swapna drishta paraloka gamanecha naiva iccha jayate तथा ज्ञानिनोपि बंध भ्रांति निवृत्ति रूप विदेह मोक्ष परित्यागे स्वर्गादि परलोक गमने च नैव इच्छा संभवति. A person who wakes up from swapna does not have इच्छा towards swapna padartha, swapna loka. Even if it is there, he can't get it. Why? Because he has woken up. That world has ended. Similarly, when one wakes up to jnana, one won't have iccha towards this swapnavat jagrat prapancha. Even if one has it, jagrat prapancha includes the paraloka. Even if one has iccha, one can't get it. Why? It is over. Just like swapna is over, you cannot get the same swapna again. You may see similar things in another swapna, but for that you have to go to sleep. Similarly, the jnani has to go to sleep. He cannot go to sleep because ajnana, the karana, nidra vat. Ajnana is destroyed. So, there won't be this paraloka gamana swapnavat jagrat. Bhoga won't be there. Back to Mula. बंध भ्रांति अभाव एव सशरीरस्य ज्ञान जीवन मुक्ति इत्युच्यते. सॉरी, या वी लेफ्ट समथिंग. सो हियर व्हाट डिड वी, वी डिडंट सी दी 486 आवर्त. 486 आवर्त से ज्ञानिनो मंद प्रारब्ध वशा जीवन मुक्ति सुख विरुद्ध प्रवृत्ति ही बिकॉज ऑफ मंद प्रारब्ध. पीस ऑफ there is uttama prarabdha where a person would be always a vairagi, but then madhya prarabdha is there where one may have bhoga even after pre jnana, but after jnana there would be vairagya. But in the rest of the three cases, what happens? There is bhoga prarabdha, which can be of any level based on purva samskaras. So manda prarabdha vasha jivan mukti sukha viruddha pravrutti. The pravrutti is opposed to jivan mukti sukha. How so? The same atmananda is manifest everywhere, but still if it is manifest through vishayas in the antakkarana and not directly in the antakkarana, then it is nishiddha really for ajnanis. For jnanis there is no niyama which is applying, but prarabdha takes the jnani to any vishaya, whether through punya or papa. Thereby, this sukha will be less manifest through the vishaya because it is avachinna. Jivan mukti sukasya virodhini vartamana sharirastadikam bhogechha bhiksha bhojanadivat janakadinam sambhavati. So this ichha is also manifest in the antakkarana of a jnani due to prarabdha. Like in the case of Janaka, vartamana sharirastha adhikam vartamana sharirastha adhika bhogaiccha. So more bhoga in the same sharira in which you have got jnana, there can be more bhogadiyu, therefore bhoga ichcha will also be manifest in the antakarna. Bhiksha bhojana adivat, like it is there for bhiksha and bhojana to keep the sharira alive, but there is more bhoga ichcha, not only limited to the sustenance of the sharira. Atra ayam abhipraya jnanino bhaya pravruttir na jivan mukti virodhini. His pravritti will not take away jivan mukti, it will take away jivan mukti ananda for a while. Kintu jivan mukti vilakshana sukha virodhini. It is opposed and will lead to what? Jivana mukti sukha virodha. Atma hi nitya muktaha bhrantya avidyothaya tasmin bandhav pratiyate. Atma is always free, but then there is a pratiti, bhranti of atma being bound. Yada punarjnanam jayate tadaiva vidyajanya bandha bhramo api nivartate. So tadaiva there is an akara here. Tadaiva vidya, tadaiva vidyajanya bandha bhramo api nivartate. This idea of atma being bound is due to avidya. So that will also go away when jnana is held on to, when nishtha is there. Jnanotpatyanantaram api. So this is for a sadhaka, but for jnani, jnana is always there. So jnanam asya asti iti jnani. And it should be what? Tatchilyena really. So jnanotpatyanantaram api na bandha brahmo jayate. Bandha brahma is not possible for a jnani, just like it is possible for a sadhaka who has jnana every now and then but can't hold on to. Bandha bhrantya bhava eva sasharirasya jnanya jivan mukti rityuchyate. And what is this jivan mukti? Jivan mukti, we saw there are two ways to explain. One is jivan mukti ananda. Ananda is there, then he is jivan mukta. Other way to say it is that bandha bhranti abhava is jivan mukti. There is no bhranti of bandha. When will it take place? Even when person is indulging, he should not feel that he is bound. That is a jivan mukta. And that is known only to the jnani, not to others. Dehadi pravritti nivrityadu chidatmani bandha bhrantir na jnani na sambhavati. Tasmad bahya pravrityapi jivan muktir na nivartate. Since there is no bhranti for a jnani, even when he is interacting, having pravritti, therefore jivan mukti will not go away. Tathapi bahya pravrittau jivan mukte vilakshanam sukham na jayate, ekagratapanna antakkarana parinama vashadeva tat sukham jayate. What happens? This jivan mukti ananda won't be there during pravritti. There will be parinama of antakkarana based on what? The level of ekagrata which is there. And ananda will depend on ekagrata. So if the pravritti is more, the ekagrata will go away based on the intensity of the circumstantial indulgence pravritti. Thereby the ekagrata may change, and based on the degree of ekagrata, the amplitude of sukha. Which is same jivan mukti ananda, but it is manifest differently. Sacha ekagrata parinamo bahya pravrutya pati pratibadhyate. So it will reduce based on more bahya pravrutti. Ittham prarabdha bheda vasha jnanino vyavaharo nana prakaraha parantu yasya prarabdham adhika pravrutti hetu tasya tan manda prarabdham ityuchyate. Wherever there is more prarabdha due, that prarabdha is called as manda prarabdha in the case of jnani. Yato hi adhika pravrutti ekagrata virodhini antakkarana so why? Because more the pravrutti, more the ekagra virodha, ekagrata virodha. Antarena cha ekagram nirupadika ananda na pratiyeta. You cannot have no concentration and still say, oh, I have understood. Similarly, jnani cannot have no nishtha and still say there is ananda. That is not possible. It is but obvious. Antakkarana can either twist within or outside. It cannot have both together. Although the jnana does not go away, jivan mukti, videha mukti don't go away, jivan mukti ananda varies. Etachya samadhi nirupana prakarane kathitam. It has already been discussed. So there are two tippanas. I'll just quickly go through it. It is just, you know, gathering what has been discussed. Sarva swatantrena भुवं पालयतु राज्ञो रोग कारणीभूतं प्रारब्धं कर्म प्रतिबंधकत्वात् मंद इत्युच्यते यथा तथा. सो जस्ट लाइक इन द केस ऑफ अ क्षत्रिय राजा हु जनरली शुड हैव ग्रेट वॉरियर स्किल्स बट हिज शरीर ऑल्सो शुड सपोर्ट. इफ द शरीर इज नॉट स्ट्रॉन्ग, इफ इट इज रोगग्रस्त, हिज स्किल्स डू नॉट मैटर. Therefore, that kind of prarabdha will be called as manda prarabdha in the case of a king having roga. Tatha avidya tatkarya bhuta shatrun samrutya brahmi bhutasya jnaninaha adhika prarutti hetu bhutam prarabdham ekagrataya virodhitvat mandam ityuchyate. Or in the example itself, a king who has won many a battle but still cannot enjoy the palatial mansions and the kingdom because being he is rogagrasta, that is more fitting. Similarly, this jnani who has won over all the shatrus like a king, all the sadhanas that he has used skillfully to win over all the shatrus, which are karya bhuta, avidya and avidya karya bhuta, still he cannot enjoy the phala. Like the king who is bedridden, similarly this brahmi bhutasya jnaninaha adhika pravritti hetu bhutam prarabdham ekagrataya virodhitvat mandam ityuchyate. Since he cannot enjoy that jivan mukti ananda and has to go around, you know, for whatever reason, whether it for even if you consider that a jnani who teaches, he is also missing ananda. During that time, a jnani who studies lot of shastras, but lesser than compared to one who indulges in vishayas. So there is gradation all over. Thereby, the nididhyasana which manifests ananda is possible only through nivritti, complete nivritti. Therefore, nididhyasana is also talked about in two ways. Samadhi Rupa Nididhyasana and Samadhi Abhyasa Rupa Nididhyasana and Brahmabhyasa Rupa Nididhyasana. One who does not have Prarabdha for Ananda Bhoga so much, or rather has Prarabdha for lesser Ananda, will have different type of Nididhyasana and gradations there compared to Samadhi Rupa Nididhyasana. This is as per the Yoga Vasishta where the Saptabhumika is talked about. Whether one wants Ananda or not, that is also debatable, and one can say there is no superiority per se. But we still have more respect, at least Sampradaya wise, there is more respect for a person who is an introvert, and especially after Jnana, who remains in solitude. One who goes around and does dharma karya has respect as well. One who goes around and does less of dharma karya has less respect. One who goes around and does adharma karya loses respect. This is human behavior, onlooker's behavior. For the jnana being same, there should be no difference, but then people don't even consider that there is jnana. This is the onlooker's perspective, but what this sadhu is saying is that jnana is same, all are muktas, their prarabdha varies, therefore their ananda varies. If one says I don't want ananda and therefore I won't go to samadhi, that is also due to prarabdha. That icha for ananda is also prarabdha vashat. Not being there is prarabdha vashat. Therefore the person says I do not want it. He may even justify and say this samadhi is all nonsense. Jnani, he may laugh out at yogis. That is also prarabdha. The person does not get ichcha for samadhi, but gets ichcha for other things that may be sadhu pravritti also, but still it is pravritti. Being pravritti, it will block the ekagrata and thereby ananda. So anyway, somehow I am not able to speed it up. Since you know these topics keep on coming up again and again, they are mentioned again and again in the Grantha also. So, Sashte Tarange Uktam, some part, and Atrayam Viveka, Mandam Tivram, Tivrataram, Iti Prarabdam, Karma Trividam. So there are three categories or there are five categories as mentioned earlier in, by the Tippanakara himself. So jnanina vyavaharaha aniyataha. There is no particular rule as to the vyavahara of a jnani. This is how it should be. You cannot make such rules. He is beyond the rules prescribed in the shastra because shastra vedo api avedo bhavati. Vedopi avedo bhavati. So what is the rule? Human rules, social rules anyway do not matter, should not matter. However, the jnani as a sadhaka is trained to follow the shastra and social norms that continues to be. That is why sadhana should be more so that the jnanottaram, the vyavahara is in line with the social order and shastra order. It doesn't take away anything from jnana, but it is for loka sangraha that sadhana should be sadhu so that the vyavahara is sadhu later and long drawn. If the sadhana is intense with lot of respect for the shastra, then the same continues after jnana also. Yaduktam jnaninah sakala anatma padartheshu mithya buddhi sadbhavat na raga sambhavati atah pravrutti revana syaditi naitad yujyate. Pravrutti itself is not possible if that is the purvapakshi's aropa. Why? Because mithya buddhi sadbhava is there in the jnani. He has mithya buddhi continuously towards prapancha. Therefore, there won't be any pravrutti. Naitad yujyate. Kutaha. Why so? Why is it not a valid aropa? Yatha dehe mithyato buddho satyam api jnaninaha dehanukula bhikshado kevalam prarabdhabalat pravrutti jayate tatha yasya jnanino adhika bhogartam prarabdham vartate tasya adhika api pravrutti jayate eva. Bhikshatana is also what? It is prarabdha karma vashat. Hunger is due to prarabdha. It is not that everyone has the same level of hunger, whether a jnani or an ajnani. It is not that everyone can do upvasa. Not everyone can do nirjala upvasa. If one does nirjala upvasa, you know, one will need a hospital bed. There are people who may need hospital beds because you will need somebody who is not used to it, or somebody who is used to it but due to age factor things change. There are many a reason why one can't do upvasa. For others it is very easy. Some say, oh, you know, I can talk throughout the day but still I'll need not even a drop of water. There are lot of such people. You'll find many in Madhava Sampradaya. So you should actually respect that. After Dashmi Ratri Bhojana, they won't take even a drop, many of them won't take in a drop of water till Dwadashi Pratakala. There then they'll have a full meal, but more than 24 hours. So it is possible for some. Now that is all Prarabdha. Prarabdha is due for Upavasa or it is not due for Upavasa. Based on that, there is that kind of sharira. A person will have that kind of thought also. I should do upvasa, I should not do upvasa. All these ideas are under the influence of prarabdha. One has say over it though. Having a say and trying to go against prarabdha is free will. That is definitely there. However, the type of sharira is not under your control. Now, it was under your control earlier. That too not perfectly. It was a sum total. So you keep on doing a lot of things out of which one thing will come together and give you a particular kind of sharira. So although it is a choice, it is not a perfect choice. Therefore, this free will that you have now is the only free will. The earlier free will in choice of sharira was not perfect. Now also, if the free will is completely free, dependent on nothing, then you can have a perfect choice. Otherwise, there is nothing called as perfect choice. There is always prarabdha which influences and there is a free will which counters. Whichever is more powerful will win over. In the jnani's case, प्रारब्ध है समर्पितम स्वपुहु. सो ऑल्दो देयर इज फ्री विल ही प्रिफर्स टू यूज इट इन लाइन विद द प्रारब्ध वेयर ही डज नॉट एक्चुअली contradict it so much, counter it so much. Why? Because the more he counters, the more satyata is being given to things around, which shows jnana is not sthira. Anyway, that's an aside. So just like bhikshatana is possible, and bhiksha also, there is madhukara vritti as well as there is ajgara vritti. So one may not go for bhiksha, one may stay wherever one is. If the bhiksha comes, well and good, otherwise upavasa. If a person goes around also, there also n number of houses, 3 houses, 5 houses max, whatever is the rule as per the sampradaya, tat tat sampradaya. If one gets bhiksha, okay, does not get upavasa. So there are pravrittis like that as well, whereas there are others who will have a, you know, 7-course, 8-course meal every day. Possible, jnani, but still possible. All is prarabdha. Just like that, other than the sharira sthiti, karma is also due to prarabdha. Iccha is also due to prarabdha. Yathacha aindrajalika mayam michha iti jananto api taddidrikshaya sarve janaha pravartante tatha sarveshvapi padarteshu michhyato buddhau satyam api tadbhogartam jnaninah pravartante. Just like you know that this magic is all fake as in there is nothing which is really created, it appears to be there, but still you'll enjoy the show. People enjoy the show even knowing that it is all magical, it is not real, doesn't stop you from saying that, oh, it is awesome. Makes you wonder, so wonderful, but still it is all maya. Knowingly you go and pay for the show and watch something which is fake, so to say, not really created, still you enjoy it, you pay money for it. So it is not that just because you know you cannot appreciate, just because you know that it is mithya you can't appreciate. In fact, it, you can appreciate more because it is no longer a trap. Patra akshepa samadhani. In this topic there are more akshepas and samadha, and this is the final, you know, the final part in this topic. Yasya punah yasmin padarthe dosha drishtirasti tatra tasya raga eva na bhavet tasmat pravrutirapi tasya tadadhina na syad iti chet tatra idam samadhanam. One who has dosha drishti in sadhana avastha itself, sadhaka avastha itself, that person cannot have raga towards that thing where he had dosha drishti. Therefore, pravritti cannot be due to this basis that you are explaining, tadadhina. Pravritti is not, cannot be based on that thing which one has dosha drishti towards. Iti che tatra idam samadhanam. If that is the question, the answer is yasya apatyasya sevanena अन्वय व्यतिरेकाभ्याम रोगाधिक्यम तत्र दोष निश्चये सत्यपि यथा प्रारब्धवशात् रोगिणः जानतः अपि प्रवृत्तिर्जायते प्रारब्ध बलात् तथा. So an example given, an easy to understand, easiest example to understand would be a person who is diabetic or somebody who has high blood pressure. What is the pathya for the diabetic? Do not eat sweets. Do not take sugar. But the person likes sugar, likes diabetes. If it is not really hereditary or a different type, usually it is due to, can be known in the same janma due to person having eaten lot of sweets, etc. Whatever it is. Now this person can't give up overnight. He cannot give up. Why overnight? Over a period of time also he can reduce, but can't give up sweet completely. I've seen purohitas who go for vaidika karma, and after vaidika karma the bhojana will have sweets. They are used to eating it, and it is not that they don't want to eat or want to eat, they are served and then they are served forcefully. It is cultural. No, you have to take this, you have to take it. So they have eaten multiple places over time. Many of them have diabetes. Can they give up at a later stage? It is not possible. They can't stop going to Vaidika karma, because also being livelihood, jivika. And if they go there as a prasada, as whatever a little has to be eaten, and once you eat a little, then you want a little more because you like it. This is human nature. Even if you know it is not good for my diabetes, the buddhi is overshadowed by the craving for sweet. What happens then? Is it possible? Yes. What happens? Whatever suffering is there, that will take place. Prarabdha vashat. Person who should not take much oil, salt, etc., who is high blood pressure patient. But even being hypertensive, the person will not like bland food. What is this? As it is, the salt is less. Salt leads to anger also. This person is already angry. On top of that, you give him less salt. This is tasteless food. I need salt. Even knowing a person craves it, and this is expandable to every raga. Every raga, every dvesha. Janan api. So, janata api yatha pravrittir jayate prarabdhavashat roginaha janataha tatha. ज्ञानिनो अपि सर्वव्यवहारेषु प्रवृत्ति सत्यामपि दोष दृष्टौ जायते एव. सो बोथ वेज, प्रवृत्ति इज आल्सो पॉसिबल एंड इवन व्हाइल हैविंग प्रवृत्ति ज्ञान डज नॉट गो अवे, दोष दृष्टि इज देयर. बोथ वेज यू कैन रीड. सत्यामपि दोष दृष्टौ प्रवृत्ति ही सर्वव्यवहारेषु जायते. So this is saptami, dosha drishti, dosha drishtau satyamapi. That is the sati saptami really. However, you can also say that dosha drishti does not go away, or even when dosha, in the question, as an answer to the question, yes, dosha drishti being there also it is possible. Pravritti is possible, sarva vyavahareshu. So this should be read as sarva vyavahareshu pravritti hi jayate eva. Kada? दोष दृष्टौ सत्यामपि, इवन व्हेन देयर इज दोष दृष्टि. इत्थं ज्ञानिनो व्यवहारे न नियमोऽस्ति, अयं च पक्षा सविस्तरं सविस्तरं तृप्तिदीपे विद्यारण्य स्वामीभि प्रतिपादितः. सो इन पंचदशी यू कैन लुक एट मोर डिटेल्स. देयर इज नो नियम फॉर अ ज्ञानी एंड एवरीथिंग इज अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ प्रारब्ध. तस्मात् तत्वदृष्टे ज्ञानिनो व्यवहारो अनियत एव. सॉरी, तस्मात् या तत्वदृष्टे, तत्वदृष्टे ज्ञानिना. सो तत्वदृष्टि वाज आल्सो द फर्स्ट सन हु वेंट टू द गुरु इन दिस ग्रंथ. सो आई वाज वंडरिंग व्हाई इट इज सेड तत्वदृष्टो. तत्वदृष्टे ज्ञानिना, वन ज्ञानी हु हैज तत्वदृष्टि, फॉर हिम व्यवहार इज अनियत. यू कैन नॉट से इदम इत्थम, दिस इज द व्यवहार. अतएव समाधि रूप नियम विधि श्रुत्वा तत्वदृष्टि परिजहास. Very interesting. So here the talk is of tattva drishti also. Tattva drishti is also there. So tattva drishti parijahasa shrutva, he was very happy listening to this. There is tarka drishti also. So you can read this as tarka drishti also was happy. I would read this as tarka drishti, but tattva drishti has been mentioned. I think that it is a typo, but it can be tattva drishti also because he is still there. However, since it is taught to tarka drishti, therefore also you can say it is tarka drishti. If you read tattva drishti, then he is already in samadhi ananda bhoga. He comes out once in a while. That is another way to read it. So ataeva samadhi roopa niyama vidhim shrutva, having heard about this, he smiled. He was very happy that he is reached there. This is tattva drishti. If you look at tarka drishti, then he is also happy because there is no niyama. And he may have some bhogechha which is validated by the guru. We'll look at, there's a long tippana. We'll see how much we can see. And then we'll continue with the story. and story there. So the teaching part is over. Now we look at what this tarka drishti, tattva drishti, desha kalad, dhyanepeksha, deha pata. So what happened to tattva drishti, ityadi? We'll have a look at the story. There is a sum up of the story towards the end of the grantha. This is also quite a long section because other darshanas are discussed which are not covered in the shad darshanas per se. The others which are new or not based on Veda proper, they are based on Agamas, Tantra, etc. These are looked into by Tarka Drishti in his lifespan. That is being discussed. We'll have a look at that in next part. Sukhan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Nam Rupi Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhya Dhrukyatya Nirma Param Sar Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Parama Tadeva Namatto Niti Minishitamati Hi Om Tat Sat Namaste.